What's up, y'all? It's your boy Lucha Guy, and I'm back with another video. This is just going to be a quick thoughts about MLW Fusion Alpha. It was okay. It wasn't like what I thought. I'm going to be real, just basically MLW. They're just calling it this Fusion Alpha because of, I don't know, I guess it's just a mini series leading into the next season. As we already know, it's just 4 weeks. So they're already down one episode. Next week's show, I'm not going to lie, looks a lot better. It's going to be a luchador match. This show did, I liked it the first match, and then I liked it it was a mid-card match with some little small guy in pink. He was pretty good. I mean, I did see a few different talents on here, but I'm just still, I don't know, I expect a little bit better. I don't know why. Maybe because it was something about it's going to be like an invasion with Azteca Underground. Maybe the invasion is yet to come, but I know we did see, my favorite scene on here was backstage with Dario. I don't know, you call him Caesar Dorian, you call him Dario, it doesn't matter to me, but Dario was backstage, and then it was some guy, it took me a while to realize who it was, bald guy, small, with a beard. It was Matt Cross, that's Sons of Havoc. So he was backstage with Sons of Havoc. I thought that was pretty cool. I mean, that was the best scene of the show. The first match was pretty good. The Von Erich guys and I think Filthy Rich. That match was good. And then the some little small guy in pink versus another guy on. He had on his pants. I think GM or something was on his pants. Some small. I'm trying to think of the guy's name later on. But yeah, the first two matches I thought was the best. The main event with TJ Perkins and Davey Richards or whatever. The match didn't suck, though, but I just thought it was maybe a bit long. It was more of a spot fest. Like, I think it's something you'll get if you're probably a guy who likes like AEW or something like that. You know, that's that type of like match there for something like if you're a fan of the AEW type of stuff, the flying, the kicks, the flips, you know, that's the obvious entertain. Let's just say what it is, the smarks. I didn't hate it, but like I said, that's for like the AEW fans. If you're a fan of that, you probably would have loved that match. I said next week's show seems better. I really hope that they really start giving us something else though. Like, cause they said this is supposed to be an invasion angle of like basically Azteca Underground invading MLW. So far in this show here, we couldn't really see it. There was a guy who we didn't even get to see that approached Dario backstage. They got to show his his office. It was basically this. It was an Azteca Underground sign. It was signed photos of Dario in there. It was a photo of like this map thing. I don't know if it's gonna come into play with anything. It's like more ancient tribe stuff of Azteca stuff, and like it's like to me some temple or something. Maybe I guess this is gonna be coming in a place where this Azteca Underground actually is real, the real Azteca Underground at this here, because this is basically MLW with Azteca Underground possibly like interfering or whatever, invading or whatever. So hopefully this is like this, we're gonna get more hints of what he's up to or whatever. This show here, like I said, I can really tell what is his plan. He spoke to a few guys backstage. He's just more of a matchmaker right now, Caesar Dorian. There wasn't much, like I said, to give the viewers a go on this first show. It was more of MLW's big return. So all this here was basically what was filmed on the July 10th show. As they're still talking about they're in Philly. As it took me around on to something like, so they're still in Philly. But I'm like, no, they must have filmed this on the same day of the July 10th stuff. So, yeah. But next week, they're going to have the Aries, the Azteca Underground Luchador that he had signed over the summer. So we're going to see what he's about, and I'm excited for that. Now, I do want to talk about something else, because this video is going to be too small to talk about Azteca Underground. Sunday is going to be the season finale of Power Book 3, Raising Kanan. Who do you guys see winning this war? Unique or Kanan's family, Raquel, his mom? I'm going to be real. Who I see winning this war is, I see Unique going to jail. I see them framing him for the shooting of Detective Howard. Raquel might be on a run. I think eventually she might get killed or go to jail herself. Who's going to obviously win this war and take over the streets is going to be Breeze. We have yet to see him, and unless this is going to wind up being D-Wiz's brother. That makes the most sense. That's who taught Kanan how to play chess. You guys can go check out a channel called Movie Boat. He broke this down today in this video this morning. I do think that D-Wiz's brother makes the most sense to be Breeze, because how else would Kanan go and find him? But yeah, I'm out, guys. Hit like and Monster Lucha slam that like and subscribe button. By the way, who the hell is this other guy here? Why haven't we seen him again on our power? But peace.